Welcome to the General Building Stock video tutorial. In this video, we will provide an overview of the General Building Stock, or GBS, in Hazus, and walk through how to access the GBS and ways to modify its data. The GBS is a collection of building attribute and parameter data stored within the statewide databases. When creating a study region, Hazus will pull geographic and hazard-specific GBS data from the state dataset that will be used to calculate a hazard's impacts for your study region. For example, the GBS is what tells Hazus how many wooden buildings there are or what the total economic value is of the various structures within a census block. Depending on the hazard your study region is set up to model, different pieces of the GBS are used. Even though this information is a default part of Hazus, you can modify these data if you have updated or scenario-specific information that you'd like to include for your scenario. The easiest way to view the GBS for an area is to create and open a study region in Hazus. As you can see, we have a study region open of Miami-Dade County for modeling flood hazards. To locate the GBS, open the Inventory menu and hover over the General Building Stock submenu. You will see a list of options that you can select to view, map, or modify slices of the GBS data. Your study region's General Building Stock submenu options will be slightly different and depend on which hazard it is modeling, since different GBS attributes are important for modeling each hazard's impacts. In this scenario, we see options for the flood modeling GBS. We'll go through a couple of these to demonstrate the type of information you can access in the GBS, but it is a best practice for you to look at all of these when you build your study region. First, select the square footage option, and a dialog will appear with a grid containing the amount of square footage of each building type in your study region's census blocks. Each row represents a census block, where the first column provides the census block ID number, and the subsequent columns provide the square footage of each type of building in that census block. As you can see, the second column is labeled Res 1, representing the square footage of single-family dwellings. As we scroll through the grid, we can see the square footage of the rest of the residential building types and other occupancy types. These occupancy type abbreviations are explained in another section of Hazus. To see the definitions for each of the occupancy type abbreviations, navigate to the main menu of an open study region and open the Inventory menu. Hover over the View Classification submenu, and then select the General Building Stock option. A dialog will appear with a grid containing the different GBS classifications. The first column contains the abbreviation, the second column contains the general occupancy type, and the third column provides the full description of that specific occupancy type. Information in the GBS is based on regional generalizations about building characteristics. Adjusting these data to reflect actual local building characteristics will significantly improve the accuracy of your study region models. Any text in blue is uneditable, but the text in black is editable. For example, we can change Hazus's loss calculation, which is a relation between a building type square footage and estimated building value, by going to the column marked Res 1, entering a field, and typing in 0. Now, Hazus believes there is no square footage of Res 1 buildings in that census block to begin with, meaning there can be no loss in that area for Res 1 buildings. This is why entering more accurate building characteristics will increase your model's accuracy. It is important to note that any changes you make to the GBS will only apply to this study region. If you wish to make it applicable to every study region, you will need to use the Comprehensive Data Management System software. See those videos for more information on that process. You can map the GBS by selecting a column and clicking the Map button at the bottom. Then close the dialog to save your changes, and you will return to your study region to view the results. Now we will go back to the General Building Stock submenu and select Valuation Parameters. A dialog will appear with a grid containing the values Hazus uses when calculating the cost of replacing buildings in your study region. The second tab provides further subclassifications for Res 1s and their valuation parameters based on the variations in single-family dwellings. Parameters like this one are important to view and understand because they drive Hazus loss estimations in your study regions. These parameters can be a source of statistical uncertainty or error in your model results to the degree that they do not reflect your study region's actual building characteristics. These specific parameters are not editable, so we will simply close out to return to our study region. Now, return to the General Building Stock submenu to continue to explore the other information contained in the GBS. Congratulations! In this video, you learned about the GBS, including how to access it and modify the GBS data. Look for more Hazus video tutorials on the FEMA YouTube channel.